So now that we have a prototype, we're moving to the validation stage, right?
That's right. The validation stage answers the hardest question in product design. The hardest question in product design is, how do you know if your work is any good?
Okay, that's an important question.
It's very important. How we answer this question has three different stages. At Google, we use something that we call triple validation. Just like in the beginning, we looked at the problem from the perspective of business, technology, and users, at the end, we want to validate the solution from the same three touch points. The most important opinion and the most important vote in validation is that of the users. So, the critical piece not to miss is the opportunity to test your prototype with real users. We recommend sprinters and the sprint lead recruit users from the very beginning of the sprint so they know that at the end the users are coming.
Right.
And they have to prepare for it, and else the all the efforts that they have spent with prototyping could go to waste because they don't actually know if this is solving the needs that users have. So meeting the users at the beginning is useful to learn their needs, and meeting them at the end is crucial in order to test. This type of test is called a usability test or a cognitive walkthrough. It allows a team to put the product or the early prototype in the hands of a user and watch them walk through all the different stages. What do they like? Where do they get stuck? Do they understand what the idea is about? And is it solving the needs that they have and that they expressed earlier on?
Do I need to explain to the user what he needs to do?
You know, what we like to do in this stage is kind of like, it's based on one of the ideas of writing. Show, don't tell. A great design prototype should be able to stand on its own without too much explaining. Generally, we'd like to set up the user and say, imagine you're shopping for a new product, or imagine you're looking to write a review, and now tell me what you see, and now tell me what you're doing from here. So we ask the users questions and ask them to imagine themselves solving a specific scenario, and we watch what they do. We ask them questions to clarify, but we're not trying to sell the product to them. One of the mistakes that people make in this stage is that they imagine this as a marketing pitch, and they start explaining how awesome the product is or why they love the idea. This is a useful approach if you're trying to recruit that specific person to buy your product, and they might just because they're trying to be nice. But this approach does not answer the critical question, is the product any good? That you force someone in person to buy something is very different from creating something that's popular and that works on its own.
That people love.
That's right.
Exactly. And are users the only people I want to get in front of this prototype?
Well, the user validation is one of three points in the rapid evaluation process. The other two points involve the business and the technology. It's really useful to test with the stakeholders of the team. Is it still meeting the business goals? Is it still answering the promises that you made to investors or the goals that you have as a company? And if yes, fantastic. And if no, we need to go back to the drawing board. More often than not, teams are aligned with the business goals and the stakeholders are happy with the results. But if you skip that validation, they might not approve the design or block it at a later stage. So having a quick check-in with the stakeholders, even if they didn't attend the entire sprint, can be very useful at this stage.
Very cool.
Another piece that's important here is doing a technical check. A design solution that's beautiful but no one can implement, it's only so valuable. So what we want to do is encourage teams to check in with the technical staff. Is this still going in the right direction in terms of feasibility? And if this seems challenging, let's clarify what are the pieces here that seems like they're going to take the longest, and how might we be able to point the design in a way that's not creating hurdles and is something that we can test and deliver quickly.
Okay, so what I'm hearing is we need to do three validations. Validate with users, validate with business stakeholders, and validate with technology people.
Yeah, these validations can be rather quick. A user test can be 20 to 30 minutes, and you can test with three or four or five different people. For most teams, that they even test with one person is already a success. The business validation can be a 5 to 10 minute discussion or longer if the issue is very problematic. Or the technical validation can be similarly short, 5 to 10 minutes. We're doing this as a best practice, sort of like covering a checklist to make sure that all the possible ways in which something can fail to deliver after the sprint are addressed, and that also people are bought into the solution, which makes it easier to deliver afterwards.
So what could go wrong in this stage?
That's a great question. What could go wrong is that teams can be overly confident in their own solution and skip the user testing. That is a common a pattern that we see with teams that are new to sprinting. They think, well, we can do the user testing later. It is true that the user test can be done separately from the sprint, but that is a myth. While the team is together and they're fresh in the space of all the prototyping, it is really valuable to right away get feedback. If you do the user test with your whole team present and right after the creation session, this keeps the need to write any research documents and it keeps all the ideas fresh in their minds. That makes it that much more likely that the products and the problems will get addressed in the next phase.
And what happens if they don't like the solution, if the users hate it?
Well, if the users hate the solution, it's a great opportunity to learn. We try to be humble with our designs. After all, we only spend 2 to 5 days working on them. We hope that the life of the company will be much longer than that, so those 2 to 5 days were valuable if we learned something. So, if the users don't like something, it's a great time to seek to understand again. So we go back to the first way of thinking, which was let's understand. What is it that they don't like? Is there something that could be solved better? Asking questions and probing deeper into the things that users don't like is a great opportunity. The best time to learn is that users don't like something is right after you have created the prototype in 2 to 5 days, and not after you have spent 2 years of your life telling everyone you love and maxing out your credit card. This is a great idea.
So in this stage, we take the users, we let them play with the prototype, and we listen to them.
That's right.